trying to solve was lots of volunteers were coming together to create masks to donate.
These masks were going to be replacing commercially made surgical masks. We wanted to compare how the commercially made masks perform to the masks that people are making at home.
The great thing is that we have some wonderful experts at Northeastern, and one of those folks is somebody who'd done mask testing back in the 80s. And what they found there was when you had a mask that didn't fit very well, one way that you could improve the fit of that mask was by taking a section of nylons and putting that over the mask. So it just pushes the mask more tightly into the face. We included that in our set of experiments as a measurement of figuring out how well the mask fit. The TSI port account is the instrument that's commonly used to evaluate efficacy of N95 and respirator masks. And it does that by measuring the particle count in the room and also measuring the particle count behind the mask and comparing those two numbers. We would test each mask, and then after we had done that, we would put a layer of nylons over it. So it's essentially cinching the mask up to the face and then run the test again.
Between the surgical mask, the cone-shaped mask, and the duckbill mask, what we have found is that the surgical masks do best when they are held on with a nylon layer because there are a lot of gaps that are present, right? They don't fit perfectly. The cone-shaped masks fit better, so they are not as improved with a nylon layer. The duckbill also has a very good fit. They're not usually improved wearing a nylon overlayer.
The goal of this research was really for folks to be informed. As engineers, our goal is to build things that help people, to build things that work and that solve problems.